Hi, and welcome to this edition of Bobcat Update. I'm Samantha Carlson.
And I'm Anya Bocaria. Today we'll tell you what to do to prepare for graduation, and we'll tell you what Bobcat fans can expect this Saturday. The U.S. Supreme Court is hearing its first abortion rights case in 5 years. Today the court wrestled with how to handle a New Hampshire law that requires a parent to be told before a daughter ends her pregnancy. According to the Austin American-Statesman, some justices said they were troubled by the fact that the law doesn't make an exception for minors who have a medical condition. The court has in the past said abortion restrictions should include a health exception. If Samuel Alito, Bush's nominee for the high court, replaces Justice Sandra Day O'Connor, he could be the swing vote in this case.
The fall 2005 semester at Texas State is coming to an end, and many students are wrapping up their college careers. Mastin Kirksey has this Bobcat update.
While many students at Texas State prepare for another semester of school, others are getting ready to walk across the stage at Strayan Coliseum to accept their diplomas. With the last day of class being December 5th, graduation dates have been set for the middle of the month. The early commencement on the 17th is especially important because of a guest speaker.
Dr. James Weitzel will be accepting the honor for the middies and will be delivering the keynote address. We only have a key speaker at the Saturday morning ceremony.
Commencement could last anywhere between 1 and 3 hours, depending on the number of students graduating. This year, the largest graduating group is the final group with 678 students. The other groups have fewer than 550 students each. If you're going to have family and friends in the audience, it would be a good idea for them to get there about an hour early.
There is no limitation at this time to the number of friends and family that you can invite to graduation. The Coliseum holds 7,200, so it's literally who comes, gets a seat.
For graduating seniors who haven't bought their caps and gowns, you can do so at the colloquium or the university bookstore. A package is available with cap, gown, and tassel. All you need to know is your height. If you're looking for a few other graduation-related items, the university bookstore has plenty.
We have caps and gowns, graduation announcements and invitations, the traditional Texas State ring, diploma frames, and also frames for graduation pictures, and we have alumni merchandise and gifts.
Years of homework, exams, and early morning classes are coming to an end for myself and the estimated 2,223 other graduates. I'd like to wish all the graduating seniors good luck. For Bobcat Update, I'm Mastin Kirksey.
Students hoping to get in some last-minute studying for finals can get some help from Alkeck Library. Starting at 1 o'clock this Sunday, the library will stay open around the clock until 10 p.m. on Friday, December 9th. Students will not only be able to use the library's abundant reference materials during that time, they will also be able to take advantage of the tables and desks and individual study rooms on the 6th and 7th floors. Be warned, though, that the Slack Lab will close for the semester at 5 p.m. on Monday, December 5th.
December graduates are facing what may be a tough task for finding a full-time job. Karen McDowell has more on this Bobcat update.
Finding a job after graduation can be a long and stressful process, but Texas State University's Career Services is available to help ease the mind of students and alumni. Career Services provides individual counseling, employer literature, and the contacts recent grads need to get a foot in the door.
Where would you like to work? What kinds of companies interest you? Because if we can start to narrow that down, then we can make recommendations.
A good resume is something every college graduate needs.
Resumes to me are commercials. So there are standard things that need to be in a resume, but it has to be targeted to the audience.
Career Services has an online job database called Jobs for Cats, where students can post their resume and come in contact with future employers. However, with graduation around the corner, some students are having a hard time keeping up with classes and preparing for their future at the same time.
The whole point is to graduate and find a job, but it's that whole period where you don't know where you're going to work, and you're trying to take finals and graduate and find a job at the same time, and it's difficult.
There are job postings listed all around campus like the one you see here behind me in Old Main, but if you're still overwhelmed about finding a job after graduation, you can always apply for grad school. For Bobcat Update, I'm Karen McDowell.
The Student Recreation Center is set to grow in size, but not without affecting students' wallets. The Board of Regents has authorized the university to build additions and renovate the building. The project's estimated from $47 to $94 per semester. The project will include a 20,000 square foot addition and construction of a new two-level, 80,000-square-foot expansion. The expansion will have an indoor swimming pool, rock climbing, 4 playing courts, and an exercise and weight room.
Coming up on Bobcat Update, the holiday season is underway. We'll tell you a few places to try out. Stick around.
The San Marcos Police Department provides a wealth of information for citizens. Citizens have access to information about programs run by officers, press releases, and accident reports. This information can be accessed from anywhere on the SMPD website.
On our website, we try to maintain information that we believe the public will find useful. We have some links to our public presentations where each 6 months we update the people of San Marcos on recent crime trends and crime patterns and statistics, some interesting cases we've worked on, some of our plans for the future. You can find all that on the website.
To get to the police department website, go to the city's webpage, click on departments, scroll down and click police. You can access information from the police department or the city's website by going to www.ci.san-marcos.tx.us.
The Texas State football team is playing Cal Poly in round 2 of the NCAA Division I AA playoffs on Saturday. The game will start at 3 o'clock at Bobcat Stadium. Tickets are most likely going to be sold out by tomorrow afternoon, so make sure to buy one as soon as possible. Bobcat Stadium seats 15,000 fans, and 10,000 tickets have already been sold. Tickets cost $5, $10, or $12. Should the Bobcats win, they will advance to play either the University of New Hampshire or the University of Northern Iowa.
The Texas Longhorns are hoping that the dreaded SI curse is just a myth. Texas quarterback Vince Young is on the cover of both Sports Illustrated and ESPN's magazine this week. This coming on the heels of an award-winning week for the Longhorns. Head coach Mack Brown was named Big 12 Coach of the Year, while Vince Young received Offensive Player of the Year honors. In addition, Jamal Charles and Brian Arakpo were named Offensive and Defensive Freshman of the Year, respectively. Texas will play Colorado in the Big 12 Championship game at noon on Saturday. A Longhorn win puts them in the Rose Bowl playing for the national championship on January 4th.
The holiday season is among us once again, and for some, it's a stressful time. There's a certain amount of anxiety and stress that goes along with all that shopping, but there are a few places that try to make shopping easier on your head and your wallet. Jerry Villalobos has his Bobcat update.
As the holiday season approaches, the pressure to find that perfect gift builds. But you don't have to crowd the malls and spend a fortune looking for the best presents, because there's plenty of hidden treasures right here in downtown San Marcos.
For some, shopping for gifts is a fun time, but for many, the hassle of crowded stores and malls is just too much. Luckily, shoppers in San Marcos have an alternative to the hustle and bustle of holiday pandemonium, and it's right here in downtown. The Paper Bear showcases a wide variety of gifts for people of all ages, from toys to books, posters, and even gag gifts.
We usually work really hard to get really good selections. We've got clothing and jewelry from all around the world, and all kinds of nostalgic candy and just a lot of fun things.
Shopping in smaller scale stores like the Paper Bear also offers a stress-free environment, including a friendly, easygoing staff and complimentary coffee. If that's not enough to pry you away from the cutthroat shopping seen at malls this time of year, the shops of San Marcos also have competitive prices with a more unique selection. If it's clothing that you're looking for, downtown offers an array of charming boutiques with unique clothes. Scraps and More, also located on LBJ, has a wide variety of jewelry, clothes, and other women's accessories.
We do order regularly some belts and some bracelets, pieces of jewelry, because they sell very well. But for the most part, we have different items every week.
And if you really want that Christmas feel, they'll even have a Santa Claus there this weekend taking pictures.
So before you get caught up in all the stress of the holiday shopping season, check out some of the alternatives to shopping in San Marcos. For Bobcat Update, I'm Jerry Villalobos.
The city of San Marcos is gearing up for its 19th annual Sights and Sounds of Christmas. On December 1st, 2nd, and 3rd, the San Marcos City Park will be transformed with thousands of twinkling lights and music from the Heart of Texas Chorus, as well as area school choirs. The Sights and Sounds of Christmas runs from 6 until 10:30 p.m. and is admission free as always. Be sure to come hungry, because there will be more than 30 vendors selling holiday treats, burgers, funnel cakes, cotton candy, and much more. Guests may park at the Strahan Coliseum and ride a free shuttle to the grounds.
It looks like the third time really is the charm. At least it is for one college student graduating next month. 71-year-old Virginia McNeil is finally getting her degree from the University of North Texas after trying three times before. McNeil enrolled at North Texas for the first time in 1951, again in 1984, and finally decided to stick to it in 2002. She says raising a family and running a business forced her to postpone her education. McNeil says when people ask her what she is going to do with her degree, she says, "I'm going to frame it." She'll walk across the stage to get her degree December 17th.
Well, it's better late than ever, isn't it?
Sure is. Thanks for tuning into Bobcat Update. I'm Samantha Carlson.
And I'm Anya Bocaria. Tune in tomorrow.